Up, everybody, it's your boy CG back at you guys again with some more crypto information, news, and just talk. Now, today's hot topic, of course, is gonna have to be, as we all know, founder of Litecoin, Charlie Lee, spreading his FUD earlier, fear, uncertainty, and development. For those of you who are new to the crypto space, that is what FUD is, and Charlie today, I don't know if it's still on there. It may still be on there. Let's take a look. Charlie actually, I don't know what possessed him to say that, knowing that he's practically a sphere of influence at 120,000 followers. A lot of the crypto community, not just most, a lot of them just, you know, listen to him every word he says, you know. Well, it's not here anymore. He even deleted the post where he was like, F this. But yeah, just he FUDded earlier. Crazy. He basically said that he has a trusted source stating that China has officially banned Bitcoin exchanges, so on and so forth. And, you know, a lot of people were just getting on him all day. It was like he threw himself in a ring with no gloves, and people were just beating on him all day. And then I guess he finally deleted the post, and then he posted another tweet after that. And man, it was kind of crazy today. I really wish I had caught it like a snapshot. But yeah, that's why the markets are so down today. As you guys can see, Bitcoin is down heavy today. Bitcoin, Ethereum, and there's a lot of red across the board. Even when Bitcoin was, you know, just yesterday was starting to make a little, it was starting to bounce back from the market thing. But yeah, you know, that's just parts of the trial, test of the jungle. Cause you know, for us seasoned veterans, this isn't anything new. And to watch just people with weak hands just dropping and selling off, not understanding what they hold, it's just kind of sad. But it's not sad because then you really see, you really get to understand the mindset of others, and it really actually helps you build your own mindset and strengthens it, you know? That's just one thing you could take from this. You know, you guys can even come down here, and it's actually pretty good buying climate for a lot of you who are interested in what's going on as far as what coin to get into. Just some honorable mentions. I'm not a financial advisor, everybody, but Golem is doing good. It's a nice grab right here at 28 cents right now. Just some good ones off topic. You know, Komodo was really good. Komodo's been doing its thing the past couple of days, and it's been through heck for the last minute. Civic is going to be key in the future. A lot of people are sleeping on Civic after the ICO, and they just kind of left it alone. People took their profits and left. But Civic, man, a lot of people are asleep on this. Civic, as a matter of fact, for those of you who didn't know, Equifax, or was it TransUnion? It was one of them. I think it was Equifax, though. Equifax actually had a leak. A hacker got into the Equifax systems, and over 140 million Americans' identities were stolen. Like private information, like their social securities, names, addresses, numbers, drivers, like, you know, all of that private stuff that you really could take and go whatever you can do with that type of information. They have it. And now, so who knows, God knows what's going to happen when a lot of these people start seeing like hotels, houses, cars pop up in their names all over. And who can you blame but Equifax? You know, I can only imagine the steam that's about to head towards Equifax, the boiling hot steam, like volcanic steam. But yes, Civic is definitely going to be a big contender in the future, especially when it comes to people's trusted information. I actually plan on getting my own, signing up with Civic. Not just, people only see cryptocurrencies for the coins and the money, but these things have actual uses, people. Like the same things that you're talking about, that's the reason the price is going to go up, is the same thing you can actually benefit from. This is why I'm telling everybody, you can really benefit from incorporating blockchain technology into your life. And a lot of people are going through Civic's actual, you know, platform and securing their personal, well, their private information. A lot of people, Civic saw actually a shoot up in the last couple of days. Civic got listed on I believe Poloniex the other day, and a lot of people after the Equifax event have been turning to Civic and just getting on the train. Civic is the future, everybody. Civic is one of the pivotal cryptocurrencies of the future. It's gonna be extremely important, so keep an eye on it. That's actually another good pick. But yeah, besides that, we have things that just stand out to me personally. There's probably a lot of golden nuggets in here that I'm not looking at right now, but just things that pertain to me right now. I still need to look into Walton. I've been hearing so many good things about Walton, and it's just another thing. But it seems like Walton's its highs are higher than this, but still, this is a pretty good entry point. No limit coin, no limit coin, 22 cents. Oh, all of you people who were wondering about no limit coin ever since the little Chinese FUD started floating around about Chinese exchanges. A lot of Chinese people dumped, and the thing about it is, no limit coin is such a strong coin that it's definitely gonna bounce back. It has an actual project behind it, and a lot of people, they don't see the fact that no limit coin has an actual strength. There's a system behind it. You have to believe in your investment, people. That's why a lot of people, a lot of these weekends that dump no limit coin, they don't know what they had. They don't truly understand it. But hey, what can I say? There's a lot of ways around. Even if this Chinese ban stuff, even if there's even in that particular instance that it is like real factual stuff, there are so many ways around it that it's kind of hard to believe that people would really sit here and dump their coins. You could even download a no limit coin wallet and hold your no limit coins on there till whatever happens, and it gets on other exchanges and send it to your other exchanges. It's really simple ways around this, and people, I don't know, people just think about cryptocurrencies. They want to put themselves through the fire and the hoops when they could really just hold their coins, because cryptocurrencies aren't going nowhere. They literally crypto the person who made the first Bitcoin doesn't even understand that he really opened up Pandora's box, literally. And it's you can't close it. Once you do that, you can't close it. Well, that's just a couple honorable mentions. Pillar as well. Pillar has a bright future as well. Pillar is really cheap right now, really, really cheap. Pillar has so much room to grow in the future that I feel like that's another cryptocurrency that's really slept on. But yeah, the future of just Bitcoin is cryptocurrencies. A lot of people don't understand. Like, we have all these bankers, top hot shots, who think that they're just the perfect example of the American citizen, or not, or even just the financial advisor, whatever it may be, or just down talking Bitcoin. And the people who down talk Bitcoin are the same ones who don't want you to make any money. They're the same ones. They want you to put all their money into their bank, so on and so forth. You're taking money from their bank. Like, to be honest with you, if I was in a financial system of some sort, or in some type of financial corporation, man, I would have took to Bitcoin so fast. Just understanding just the benefits that come with cryptocurrencies in general. A lot of people, not even just people, but just there's so many misunderstandings like that people have about Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies and the purpose of it. Like, for instance, Ripple, man. If I told you, like, the only thing I see in Ripple was that flip that came when Ripple ran all the way up. That was the only thing I saw in Ripple. Ripple is still a centralized piece of crap. That's just my personal opinion. You take it how you want to. Fiat is dying. Like, it's going down the hill. The freaking debt ceiling is going crazy right now. Trump signed some stuff, then the debt ceiling is going to go way up. It's crazy, like, just where. If you really look at these coins and what's behind them, and you really analyze them, a lot of these coins are not as, decentralized as you may think they are. Not all of them. I mean, that's the primary premise behind cryptocurrencies in general, the decentralization. But some of them have some stuff going on underneath that you probably don't know about, and Ripple is one of them. Ripple is definitely a centralization city. It's the capital of centralization. But yeah, beyond that, a lot of people just don't understand their investment. That's why there are so many weak hands. I will only say go stand in the test of time. A lot of people, don't understand just how big Omise Go is going to be. I mean, McDonald's has already started, integrating Omise Go into their payment systems in certain parts of the world. I can only imagine what happens when it goes mainstream. Omise Go is going to be freaking huge, man. A lot of people are underestimating the gravity of holding these cryptocurrencies and where they can go in the future, where they can't take them. Vibe Hub as well today ended their 5% sale. It's officially you get what you get. You get what you pay for. One ETH equals 100 Vibes. No bonuses, but definitely good tech. Definitely going somewhere in the future. You guys can still add me on ONG if you. I actually was just watching this. This is a really good video. Crypto Daily. I love this dude. He had a really funny opening to his video today. If you guys do subscribe to him, check out this video. Yeah, he just delivers good content in general, but this dude's a character. Awesome. Awesome content. That's what I'm here for. Just bringing value, seeing people prosper, And just getting people's minds right. A lot of people don't have their mind in the right place, and they're not gonna prosper in the long run. If you don't have the proper mindset for these type of investments, a lot of people want to, like I said, jump through the hoops and ladders and do all these extra stuff with the cryptos, like day trade, this, that. It's so much simpler. Like I said, guys, I've been saying this since I came on this channel. Hold your coins, HODL. You don't know. You don't know what you really. I'm not saying you can't miss. You can't not miss. I'm not saying you can't win in day trading, but I mean, if you look at it, instead of day trading, you could really just be allocating your funds into something. I mean, unless you win really big, you have like six figures to throw around, 50,000, 80,000, 90,000. Shit, go ahead, do what you want with that. But there are a lot of people out here who really just devote their whole portfolio to day trading and lose it all in the process, when you really could just be holding your coins, loading up on coins when it's cheap, and then just stashing them away, loading up on some more coins when it's cheap, stashing them away, and just prepare yourself for the future, because it's in for a long ride. It's a roller coaster ride, and a lot of people don't seem to understand just how fast it is. It's like we're not even at the top of the roller coaster yet. Like, we're literally building up. It's like we're going all the way up to that point, at that inertia point. Then when all that kinetic energy just is released, it's gonna go crazy. We're still building up inertia. So a lot of people don't see that. They're new. So as a seasoned person, you just have to really just understand the fact that there are people who are not gonna understand this investment. And that's actually another thing. I feel like that's why Bitcoin is standing. It's still sustaining its $4,000 price range, because I feel like that's all this is big hands, like government corporations and stuff, who are under the table buying up Bitcoin, and seasoned vets who know what the future has in store just for this entire space. But yeah, that's it, everybody. I'll come back at you guys tomorrow with some more information, more talk. I'm gonna start doing this more. Like talking. It's like I'm thinking out loud now. I prefer, like, I want to start doing that with my chats more. Just start thinking out loud more. Do my review for the day, and just have just think out loud session. But yeah, everybody, this is your boy CG. Peace. I'm out.